We see that customers nowadays are not only looking for products, services, or values out of a brand, but are more inclined towards that special factor, which is customer experience. And this is exactly what we will be discussing today. Hello, everyone. My name is Ria Vibhute, and I welcome you all to the Cyb InCync Podcast. The pandemic has made businesses reimagine the customer experience. Today, to talk more on how customer service has become the game changer in the industry and shed more light on enhancing customer experience, I would like you all to welcome our special guest, Tarun Mahajan. He is the Vice President of Support Services Department at Cybage. With over 20 years of experience setting up and leading numerous large-scale business operations, as well as international process migrations, Tarun currently heads nearly 1,000 people strong support services vertical at Cybage. We also have Shankar Yadav. Shankar is the delivery manager for support services at Cybage and has more than 18 years of experience managing cross-geography teams, enhancing process operations, and improving operational efficiencies. A warm welcome to both of you, and thank you so much for joining us today.
Pleasure is ours, Ria. Thank you so much.
So Tarun, let's start by understanding, what role does customer service play in the overall customer experience? Why has it become so significant?
See Ria, the industry is becoming very competitive. So any enhanced customer service experience surely acts as a differentiator in today's business. With a lot of information already available, customers have very, very easy means to compare products, prices. However, it's the overall service experience that helps build loyalty. So most of the organizations today have coupled personalized experience with technology, you know, that allows them to maintain a very high service standard. If the organization today has the visibility into a full customer journey, so that may include historical transactions, previous customer service exchanges, preferred contact channels, and movement from one channel to another. So if that's seamless, then companies can surely deliver a truly connected experience. You know, with the power of technology, all of this today has become very, very seamless. So this is adding the X factor, the experience factor that every customer is looking for. In addition to this, if you empower your team to be subject matter experts, it brings about the right solution in the first interaction itself and adds value that the consumers always look to. So, you know, anything which enhances the experience, which solves their issue, maybe the first time right, if they feel inclusive, their feedback is heard and implemented, the experience is enhanced, and that's the game changer to the business today.
So you mean to say everything goes hand in hand? We can't just focus on one factor.
Absolutely, absolutely. Customer service experience is as important as your product. Mm-hmm. You can't let the two be independent. It has to be coupled together.
Interestingly, I was going through a report, and that's what it stated, that a high number of customers say that service is the most important factor when it comes to brand choice or brand loyalty. Do you agree to this completely?
Certainly. You know, in the world where we are spoiled for choices, I think customer service definitely represents your brand image. It is a factor of the values that the organization has to present and how inclusive they are with the consumers, be it their feedback, suggestions, and how well they are received. Today, the customer are willing to pay more than what they receive. I would put it this way. Today, the customers are more willing to pay when they receive an enhanced experience. You know, they're okay to pay that price because they know the value of that product and the experience is high. Studies have proven that the cost of retaining a customer is way more less than acquiring new ones. So if I'm correct, it is about 5 to 7 times lesser than acquiring a new customer. So the companies are focusing their energies into retaining their current customers. It also helps them to spend less on the operating costs. So a good representation of service, be it through experience, be it through product, all of it also helps you in upselling or cross-selling. This in turn creates more marketing opportunities. So you're right that the overall statistics are moving towards experience, are moving towards brand loyalty, which is helping them retain more customer value, which is a very, very important metric.
Okay. And also to know about the company aspect of it. How do you think will this affect the company business then?
Company business, I just spoke about the customer value, right? So companies today understand the customer lifetime value, if I may just put that across, because it helps them understand the revenue they can expect from a single customer. So there are a lot of analysis that are done. There are a lot of understandings of the intent and the behavior of the customer is understood. A custom fit, protocols are put in place that allows them to know and gauge the spend. So this helps them put together a lot of insights in their decision making. Since today's customers are digital savvy, they feel empowered if you allow them with more information and also have the freedom to express them with regards to feedbacks, with regards to suggestions. You know, they feel more associated with the brand. So technology surely plays a very important role in connecting the customers with the organizations. We all have seen what artificial intelligence has done. Machine learning has got us into. Even the digital services that everybody are into, it is just being custom fit for each individual's needs. And how do you couple that with a personalized experience is what the consumers are looking for. So I definitely see a good growth aspect. The sooner the customers or the businesses start implementing technology and personalized services.
Yes, thank you so much. So talking about technology, Shankar, how do you think we can make use of technology to enhance customer experience through customer service?
Yeah, I agree with what Tarun has mentioned, that now the customers are more technical savvy. So technology really helps us to improve the customer service by speeding up the communications, increasing convenience to the customer and providing self-service options. So now technology also allows you to consolidate and have an omni-channel engagement solutions for all the customer service and support requests in one single place. To give an example, like issue raised from different channels, be it social media, chat, phone calls or emails, can be automatically now converted into a ticket or a request and can be placed in a single system. And in turn, it gives a seamless experience, the consistent experience to the customer across the platform. Having all requests in one location not only saves time, but it makes our staff much more productive. Using technology, you can automate the workflows and send timely update on the progress of the issues to the customer, which shows the responsiveness what we have towards the customer. Technology, like Tarun mentioned, the customers are more digital savvy. That technology also enable us to have a artificial intelligence based chatbot, which is integrated to the comprehensive knowledge base where customer can log in and solve their own problems. So not only for the customer, but the technology also helps the company by providing data analytics on the real-time dashboards, which help us to understand the entire customer journey and which help us to find out the gaps, which we can fix it to enhance the customer experience. So I can say that technology affects the customer in a very positive way.
It must be saving time also.
Of course. Yes. So Shankar, I would just like to add to one of the information that Shankar just provided. He spoke about that different omni channels, and one of the reasons I want to bring this along is today, the consumers are moving towards web chat, that 40% of the consumer base is very, very comfortable with only the chat option. So that's the trend, that's the inclination that we've seen, and omnichannel definitely adds that value. Shankar also brought another important point, which was self-service portal. Like, we all are very independent now. We want to know where our problem is and how can we be more empowered with information, with the right knowledge base, just to go ahead and solve the problem ourselves. So since we're becoming more independent, all these channels really make or bring an impact in this particular experience.
Yes, but on the contrary, I just wanted to ask, what challenges then will the businesses face if they do not adapt to technologies? Will they pay a heavy price for it, or it just So now they can just work on it.
Yeah, definitely. The expectations of today's customer are constantly changing. The enhanced customer experience, what we talked about, needs to go now above and beyond the traditional way of serving to the customer. Customer have started now placing their experience, like Tarun mentioned, the brand reputation, the price of the product. The customer is above over it now. So they are looking for the experience when they try to get the service, and that drives the entire business. So given the role of technology in determining the customer experience and satisfaction, without happy customers, business death is inevitable. This should be the big reason that business should understand the customer needs and invest more into new technologies that would help to keep the customer happy and satisfied. And to give you just some insight, if you see a few decades ago, the technology companies in Fortune 500 were very less. Now, if you see the current trend, there are many technology companies in Fortune 100. So that means it is clearly that the technology companies are driving the entire customer experience, and it is one of the key factors that people in the business should look into technology.
Yes. So coming back to our tech support industry, what is in it for the tech support industry? Is the shift in customer behavior beneficial, or how would we take it ahead? Tarun, we would like to hear your take on this.
Of course, we are very, very beneficial, I would put it that way. Sky's the limit, you know. It has a twofold advantage to how we are working today. You know, there are digital services that have started, which are very custom, which understand the customer's needs, have means to influence their decisions, means to easily understand what patterns a customer is following. So that is where the technology helps. The artificial intelligence, machine learning brings about the flavor of an individual custom, product life cycle or product that a consumer can buy. The second one is where we start orchestrating communication in a way that it seems like a real world, which is a very, very big thing. And one of the key aspects here is that the technology has become very intuitive. The CRMs, the live, the web chats that I was talking about, the portals that Shankar spoke about, all of this is making the business work in a very seamless manner. You know, there is good communication from the front end and the back ends, where you would need everybody to get involved. So I see a lot of opportunities coming our way, just because the personalized element of service will never die. That will continue to be there because that brings in the human factor that we all look forward to. And with these CRMs, with the portals that are coming in, with artificial intelligence, the trend, the analysis, the dashboards, the access to information that we have will only start focusing on being very customized towards the customer behavior. So we are up for good business in the support industry. Yeah.
That's nice. Thank you, Tarun. So then in that case, how do we stand out from the crowd? What do we need to do? Shankar, what do you think, what innovative technologies do businesses need to employ in order to exceed client expectations? Because everyone will be focusing on client expectations. How do we stand out?
Yeah, so in order to create a positive customer experience, Ria, today's business must find the right digital tool. So I think the technology that can improve customer experience are maybe the cloud services. Cloud technology helps to manage omnichannel interaction and integrate customer data into a central repository, which can be easily accessed from anywhere using any device via network connection. So having cloud on subscription-based scalable options, customer today does not need to worry about the uptime, the scalability, and the performance. So cloud services is one thing. Second thing is artificially intelligence-powered device called chatbot. So that are really designed to engage in the conversation with human over the internet. So you are like interacting with the human over the internet using chatbot. Each chat conversation is completely tailored and faster way of addressing customer requirement. So chatbot remains the second one. And the third one what I see is the video capabilities, that is the add-on. So you can combine with chatbot, but video capabilities has a, is a powerful digital tool. So business can use video chats for customer service to make interactive and personalized communication, which customer is looking for in the times of the need. So video chat really helps to identify the exact problem, looking into it in the real time, and deliver the immediate solution, which helps to reduce the customer touch points and improves first contact resolution, which in turn enhances the overall customer experience. So according to me, cloud services, artificial intelligence enabled chatbot, and the video capabilities really are the digital tool one should look at.
So if the present situation is this, what are your thoughts on the future? I mean, what does the future look like of customer service experience?
The future is very exciting, yeah, I can say that. And okay. I'll help you with some of the examples and you can relate to. So augmented reality is something which will be a game changer in future. And it will help us to give a seamless experience, enhance the customer experience by the way we interact and communicate with the people digitally. Just to give an example, like in today's era, augmented reality has already hit in. It is in the market. For example, if you really want to see how your living room color will be looking like, so you can go on the website of the paint companies. Try to upload your living room picture and select the paint, and you can see virtually how it looks like. Or maybe if you want to select a glass frame for your, then you can actually try to see, upload your picture, and then try to see which frame works on you very well. So these are some of the AR technologies which are already in use. But going future, this will be in the industry for long, and it will play a big role in improving customer service experience for any business.
Convenience in a click is what we are looking at. Comfort, convenience, real-time vision is what we all look
for. Yeah. So like one thing I would like to add is like not only just the technology, but the process also plays an important role by handling and giving the customer experience. So you should have the right technology, right skills, and right process to build the superior customer experience.
Yes. So to conclude this engaging session, we expect a healthy growth for the customer support industry in the coming years, I would say. So a big thank you to Tarun, you and Shankar for your thoughts and insights. And thank you all for being such wonderful listeners. Thank you.
Thank you.